Hi everyone! In MATLAB R2020A, we have shipped a new object-based framework for pricing financial instruments. With this framework, we can create instrument, model, pricer, interest rate curve, and default probability curve as objects. It allows us to streamline a pricing workflow in such a way that we can easily use different pricing models and methods to calculate the price and Greek variables. In addition, we can create a portfolio of instruments so that we can collectively calculate the price and Greek variables of the portfolio. The question that comes up very often when we introduce something new is, do I need to change the existing codes after upgrading to the new version? The short answer is no. We always think about the backward compatibility so that you can still run your existing codes from the earlier versions of MATLAB after upgrading to the new version. If you want to continue using the function-based pricing that we have, you can still do so with the new version of MATLAB. If you are the existing users of function-based pricing, you can start from this documentation page. Mapping Financial Instruments Toolbox function to object-based framework for instruments, models, and pricer. Let's scroll down to the bottom and select the instrument type that you are interested in. And you can see the step-by-step workflows for migrating from function-based pricing to the object-based framework. Now let me quickly summarize the workflow for using the object-based framework here. In most cases, you need to create three objects here: instrument, rate curve, and pricer. Then compute the price and Greeks of a single financial instrument. But if you want to price the instrument with optionality, such as options, caps, floors, swaptions, and option embedded bonds, you will need to create a model object to specify which model that you want to use for pricing. For credit default swap and credit default swap option, you will be required to create the probability of default curve, since it is a critical assumption for pricing these instruments. Last, you can learn more details about the object-based pricing framework from our documentation. Thank you very much for watching.